Hi, I'm Siu Ling Hui with part 5 of a video series about the cash flow statement. This video is about the finance activities section of the cash flow statement. The finance section of the cash flow statement shows you the cash flow impact of the financing strategies that you use to fund your business. Let's take a closer look at what goes into the finance section of the cash flow statement. In this example, I've set out some typical items that are included in the finance activities section. If your business takes out a loan, the borrowings show up as a cash inflow under finance activities. The loan can be from a bank, from you as owner of the business, from friends or family, or even your investors. As long as it is a loan to your business, the amount of the loan is a cash flow into the business. Likewise, all repayments of loans are cash outflows in this finance activities section. If your business lends you money or lends other people money, that shows up as cash outflows in the finance activities section. These financing cash inflows and outflows are reflected in movements in borrowings under liabilities on the balance sheet if your business borrowed money. If your business lends money to you or other parties, these loans show up on the asset side of the balance sheet as loans to directors or other parties or whatever you want to call it. Note that even if the money from the loan that your business takes out did not pass through your bank account, it is still shown as a cash inflow in the finance activities of the cash flow statement. For example, if your business borrows money to buy a car, the money is likely to be paid directly by the bank to the car dealership, but your cash flow statement will show the amount of the loan as cash inflow under finance activities, and the payment for the car will show as a cash outflow under investment activities. Let's say your business buys a car for $4,000 in February and gets higher purchase finance to finance the car purchase. Your cash flow statement will show $4,000 payment as a cash outflow under investment activities. The higher purchase financing will show as a cash inflow in financing activities. Nothing happened to your cash because the purchase was 100% financed by borrowings. The investment in the car will show up as a $4,000 increase in assets on your balance sheet, and the borrowings will show up as an increase in liabilities because you borrowed $4,000 in the form of a higher purchase facility. Let's say you repay the higher purchase facility with monthly installments of $100. These repayments will be cash outflow of $100 under finance activities each month. Each installment has two components, principal and interest. Only the part that represents the principal component goes towards reducing the higher purchase facility liability on your balance sheet. Overdrafts are another common form of financing for many businesses. Any change in the overdraft balance is shown under financing activities for historical accounts. But for forecasting purposes, the overdraft isn't shown under the finance activities section. Instead, it is shown under the bank balance section of the cash flow statement. An overdraft facility is like the spare petrol tank that's attached to your bank account. It is automatically drawn on if you don't have sufficient cash in your bank account to meet payments. The reason for including the overdraft as part of the bank balance when you're doing forecasts is because you're working out how your forecast cash flow will impact your overdraft. Will you need an increase in your overdraft limit, or should you consider getting other types of financing to meet your funding requirements? If your business raises equity from investors, or even if you as business owner provides money to your business in the form of equity, the amount of equity that comes in as cash shows up as cash inflow in the financing section. Cash inflows from equity raisings are reflected by an increase in the equity section of the balance sheet. Sometimes businesses raise money by using hybrids of debt and equity called mezzanine financing. Whether these end up on the balance sheet under liabilities or equity depends on whether the financing has more of the characteristics of debt or of equity. Not everything in the finance activities section ties to the balance sheet. There are also profit and loss related items such as interest expense and interest income. With financing facilities like hire purchase or chattel mortgage, repayments are usually as a fixed monthly installment amount. But each installment has a principal component and an interest component. you can separate out the principal and interest components of these types of debt facilities in the cash flow statement for greater clarity if you wish. The interest component is reflected in the expenses in the profit and loss, whereas the principal component is reflected as a reduction in debt on your balance sheet. When interest expense and interest income are included under finance activities, these items must be eliminated from cash flow from operations to avoid double counting them. I prefer this approach because it enables you to assess your core business operational strategies separately from your financing strategies. If your business receives dividends from its investments, you would make the same type of adjustments for dividend income, assuming, of course, that earning dividends isn't your core business. However, dividends paid by your business to its shareholders are not part of the adjustments in the cash flow from operations section. This is because dividend payments are not an expense. They are a distribution of profits to its shareholders or owners. Profits go into the retained earnings account on the balance sheet and build up the amount of equity or shareholders' funds of the business. Dividend payments reduce the amount of equity in the business. Dividend payments only show in the cash flow statement when the business actually pays the cash out. If a business declares a dividend but doesn't pay it until a later date, this declared dividend reduces retained earnings and becomes a liability called provision for dividend on the balance sheet. In other words, the business now has a debt. It owes the shareholders or the business owners the money until the payment of the dividend is made. Let's say your business declares a dividend in January for payment in March. The amount of the dividend will become a liability on your balance sheet in January and it will stay there until the payment is made in March. When the dividend is actually paid in cash, the cash flow statement will show the payment as a cash outflow in the finance activities section. If you want more information about any aspect of the cash flow statement or financing in general, please put your questions below in the comments or contact me through the contact page at incontextfinance.com. Master your cash flow, know your finances so that you can drive strong, sustainable business growth and thrive. Thank you for watching. If this has been useful, please like and subscribe to my channel.